Ah, that's better. Recording this one with my actual good microphone. Noticed while rendering the last episode that apparently Audacity had chosen to use my webcam microphone, which of course, as you might expect, is not of the same quality. But in any case, welcome back to Let's Play The Binding of Isaac. We're just gonna random here. We're gonna get Isaac again. I seriously don't know what to tell you about that. It's not like I'm just mashing the space bar, trying to make sure it happens. Oh god, my volume is too loud. You can probably hear a little bit of Isaac going on in the background there. I'll take care of that once we finish this room. Please give me a key. Don't give him the stick. Give me the key. Give me the key. Okay. Well, I guess it makes sense that the red one would explode into a heart when killed, but still. We don't necessarily need a key on this floor. But it would be a nice gesture of goodwill, I think, from the troll engine that butt-fucked me so hard last time. Not just in the game, by, you know, giving me very few keys, as well as, of course, only the world's most deadly pills. But also by trolling me in real life by somehow, you know, seeping into Audacity, spreading its virulent code, and having Audacity record my webcam microphone as opposed to my standalone microphone. What can I say? When it comes to Isaac so far, it's been one of those weeks. Haven't had a good run in a little while. There's been some desync and some videos as well. I don't know, man. What can I say? It's a hard job. Things need to get taken care of. Let's see what we've got in this. I don't like this item, my best friend. I'll take the Spelunker hat. This will give us access to all the secret rooms that we come across, and, you know, just from a more practical level, we are not going to get access to another D6 reroll anyway, so we might as well go with this item, rather than, what, just abandoning it? And we'll see if we can find our secret room somewhere. There we go. So, put our bomb, blow it up, pick up surprising amount of money, actually, and then the other secret room is right here as well. This is going to take all of our bombs, which sucks. Especially since we didn't get anything out of that one. But, alas, it's okay. We do have our Emperor card. Now, with the D6, we could use our Emperor card for some interesting stuff. Normally, when I get these late in the game, I save it and use it on a floor like the Womb, the Cathedral, etc., etc. But we can use this to kind of, of course, there is a fucking Tinted Rock in here that I probably will not be able to get. We can use the Emperor card to kind of make our D6 rolls a little bit better. This guy, Famine, Blue Famine does like a an arc, or a slant when he moves. That is actually kind of fucking with me a little bit. He's almost like he homes a little bit. It's not a slant, I think he's actually just homing. That's crazy. Please destroy his horse as soon as possible. Okay, there we go. Now I can relax a little bit. He does the Monstro shots as opposed to, you know, the standard Famine shots. But even those are not so hard to get away from. Really wish I had not blown that second rock, or scented bomb, that second bomb to get that second secret room. Alas, there's nothing we can do about that now. So, let's just bounce down to the next floor. Did that go particularly well? No. But, hey, there's our secret room again, as well as a library. Oh, shit. God damn it. We are running into some tricky rooms so far. Okay, so we got tons of money. We need keys desperately. But let me guess. Oh, you need keys? Best I can do is 13 bombs. If we had bombs, then we could actually go to the shop. But we need 3 of them at least to get all the secret rooms and the shop as well. Or we could just get these dudes to explode close to that wall over there. At least give us access to one of the secret rooms here. Let's try this out. Okay, so I actually want to get, like, a wider angle going here. No! Okay, like, this... Wow, fuck that. I thought I was doing something right there, but it didn't work out. Seriously! Whatever, just take it. You deserve it. Clearly you want it more than I do. My god! Troll engine... Okay, that was just bad. Troll engine, though, in full effect lately. This is unbelievable. Abysmal. Okay, so let's try not to die to the Widow here. But this is definitely shaping up so far like one of those runs where I'm like, okay, we died 2 minutes in, let's restart. Now, oftentimes those runs end up giving me better runs on the second attempt, but still, like, I can't believe the amount of bullshit that we have had to deal with so far. We're already down to half a heart. We're probably gonna die here. Or, you know, we're, the best case scenario, we're gonna be put on fucking life support. Yeah, I was gonna say, the Widow's gonna give us one heart. Get us slightly back into the game. Maybe we'll be able to swing an HP upgrade here or something, but we have no key, so we can't access the treasure room. Best we can do is go to the shop, or we go to the Okay, we're definitely rerolling Cat and Nine Tails for an HP upgrade. Best thing we can do is, I don't know, fucking bomb our way into the... Well, let's see what we got in here. Maybe we'll get lucky and get a key or something. Bomb our way into the secret room and hopefully, I don't know, pick up something amazing from that. It's pretty unlikely, though, but we'll see. Yeah, not happy with the way that this has gone so far. At all. Only one bomb, as well. I mean, I guess that's the problem with these early floors. There's less chances to get keys, but at the same time, seriously. Fucking work with me here. Slow effect is nice. That makes up for the fact that I'm not gonna get a treasure room on this floor. Although, you know, in The Binding of Isaac, you can't really afford to have that attitude. You have to have this attitude like, I need absolutely everything that we come across. Who knows? Might be a game-breaking item contained in this room right here. Sadly, the world will never know. So we're just gonna exit here. Again, spider bite, good item. Not gonna shit talk the spider bite. And of course, all these temptations that we got right off the bat, but nothing we can do about it. Item room and secret room in the very first set there. Hopefully we can pick up enough bombs and keys to make something happen. Seriously, why is it such a fucking stringent release of keys in this game lately? And of course there is our next secret room and the shop, so there's already two bomb and two key locations that I want to go to. I would be surprised if I got to go to any of them. Probably, here's what I'm thinking, we'll get two bombs or something. Neither of the secret rooms will contain anything useful. And we'll just... There's our second bomb! Okay, so let's check here. Maybe we got something cool in this room. Is it Kane's Eye? I never remember what this does. Maybe increase tiers? It looks like a tiers upgrade. I feel like I'm firing a little bit faster. Then we'll see what we got in here. Probably, I'm gonna guess, extra money or a slot machine or 1-up. Okay, I mean, that's fine. I probably could have rerolled that, actually, and gotten some good stuff out of it. But the 1-up is a decent item as well. So I'm not sweating that too much. Just blow up the TNT here, then we'll get a D6 charge. Please just give us a fucking key. This is getting comical at this point. The same way that it was comical how I was only getting bad pills in the last run. Again, slowing effect. Good item, I like it. It would be nice if we could get like another tier effect to work with it, like a common cold or something. Ah, there's our key, okay. Now I can stop bitching a little bit. What we can do here is potentially use the Emperor card. I'm thinking we go in here, if the item's good, we take it, then we use the Emperor card, so we have our D6 ready. That's Lifesteal. That's Mom's Pad. I probably should have gone with the Lifesteal, but Lifesteal is not really that good of an item. I mean, you guys have heard me bitching about it before. It's alright, but by and large, it's certainly one of those items where you can make, you know, better stuff happen with a good reroll, and I was hoping that there was basically nothing I could have done there, I guess. One more shot maybe would have gotten me out of there, but I tried. What do you want from me? Oh, I need a little bit more. A little bit more everything here. A little bit more health, a little bit more damage. As you can see, these silkworms taking like 4 or 5 hits each. That is pretty sad. Would very much welcome a damage upgrade. I want Mom's Knife. Give me Mom's Knife. It's been so long since I've had that wonderful, mystical, almost impossibly sharp item. Cuts through cans in midair. Now, we're probably gonna take damage here. Wow. Sort of got lucky. We're gonna go back to our item room, reroll the shit out of it. The only I want health upgrades, I do not want lard, because I am already feeling like I'm pretty slow. Hook me up here, man. Spider butt. You know what? We'll go with spider butt. It works like a Necronomicon, also slows all the enemies that we get. D6 is clearly not working out that well for us, so we'll stick with the spider butt. This is an item I've seen people using on the Binding of Isaac subreddit, like as far deep as the chest, so it's a decent item. I think it recharges once every 4 rooms? It might be once every 6 though. So we'll save it for our boss. And hopefully, I would like to draw attention to the fact, where the fuck are my red hearts? Normally drop, like, rain in Seattle. I don't know, I've never visited the Pacific Northwest. I was doing my best there to come up with a rainy city. Like rain in London, perhaps. Finally, we get some red heart drops. So, spider butt. Freeze. Or slow, at least. And it did a little bit of damage. Unless that was my first tier that hit. Alright, so the slowing effect should come in handy a little bit here. The main reason being that it is going to slow Peep's shots as well, which is gonna be nice for me. But I'm still doing so little damage. please deal HP upgrade, deal with the devil, Mom's Knife, because the slowing effect will carry over to Mom's Knife. This is gonna be a long fucking fight here. So we'll just keep this up. Oh, I thought I could fly. Again, highway blindness because of my last run where I had flying like the entire time. Don't stop jumping. I'll take damage there just from refusing to move. Look at the length of this fucking Peep fight. Oh my god. Help me out here, Peep. Jump yourself onto some fucking spikes or just stay still for more than 10 seconds so that I can actually do some fucking damage to you, please. Okay, this is better. Inevitably, he's gonna jump in about 2 seconds. But he doesn't move that far when he's slowed, so the slowing effect is very nice against Peep. Come on. Got a little bit left here. We're gonna survive this, although, you know, possibly only barely, depending on how much damage I take. Just keep it up, stay... Oh man, this is fucking torturous. Okay, we made it! We got a health upgrade, which is what I wanted. I can't really pick up that other half heart right now. And it recharges once every 2 rooms? If so, that is actually awesome. And I will stick with the spider butt. Moving forward, it's an item I haven't used all that often. Although I remember getting it once and really enjoying it, but and every time after that I'm just like, Book of Revelations? Yeah, sign me up. Spider butt sucks. But you know, this is what this like post-victory or post-platinum god Isaac King is for, you know, trying out new combinations and, you know, experimenting in the game that we all know and love. I wish the game would experiment by giving me a little bit of extra fucking damage. Does Kane's eye give us fucking compass or something? I don't understand what's going on here. So we should be able to melt at least. Ooh, that was close. A few of these guys. I don't like these guys at all. Our secret room is here, so we will, you know, blow that up. I would love secret room to just be chock full of keys. Let's stick with Kane's eye for now. I don't know how it works. It seems to be doing okay for itself. Because we got so much money, but we'd never get more than one key on a floor. So there's nothing we can do about it. And also, how long has it been since I've had full health? Jesus Christ, help me out here a little bit, game. I've been living on the edge Steven Tyler style for like 10 minutes now. Well, that was a good start. Extra bombs, cool. Those are gonna come in handy, I guess. Spider butt this. I didn't realize they could still shoot when they were under the effects of the spider butt. I am still kind of confused as to why I have that, why I'm able to see absolutely everything right now. But it's too late because I have seen everything. So, we'll fight whoever our mini-boss is here. I'm just glad it wasn't greed, although I guess there was no way for it to be greed anyway. Alright, mister, you know what? Give us a ton of bombs. Maybe we can make something work here. Transition those bombs into keys where the bombs are key pill or something. Or, when you die, just drop a ton of keys. I would accept that as well. I think I slowed that bomb. Are you really just gonna get up in my face like this? It's the first time I've taken damage against Wrath in a long time. This guy's being overly aggressive, though. Well, he's done. Alright, so we got Mr. Boom. I don't want Mr. Boom in my room, though, so we're gonna exit here. Could use that for, like, one bomb, but why bother? Spider butt these dudes. Sorry, I didn't mean to say dudes, I meant to say douchebags. I was saying boo-urns. I should never get close to those guys, because I always think I have more room to maneuver than I do. And they just end up destroying me. So we're gonna play the shit out of all of the things in here. Except for possibly the blood bank, because we desperately need keys more than anything else on this planet. Except maybe world peace. Okay, thanks for the money, that's really useful. Fly love, don't give me fly love, I don't want to win fly love. Good. Reason being, I want more opportunities to win keys. The bombs are fine too, I'll accept the bombs. What's the pill? Inevitably terrible. Hey, pretty fly, that's actually not so bad. Well, we are apparently never going to win from the three-headed man here. Maybe we'll get lucky and pick up some bombs from- Whoa! Okay. I mean, we don't have any keys, so our problems still abound here. Sure, give me fly love, whatever. Give me something. Give me shelter. Give me one reason to stay here. Gimme. I don't know, I'm running out of songs with gimme involved in them. Give me three steps. Okay, I mean, that's a start. At least we'll pick up some health here, but the keys are the most valuable by far. The spirit heart and regular heart are nice. Okay. Just give me the fly love, man. Really? That's like our fourth chance. Even if I'm the unluckiest man in the world, it's a decent probability of me winning that. That was our second chance at the keys and missed out on those. Inevitably, I'll win the money here. Every time this happens, there's some asshole in the comments who's like, you know, you can just, like, look at where the things go under the skulls and figure out where it lands. That is not how it works, I assure you. It's the same animation every single time. And, of course, that time I actually tried to follow it. It seemed like I picked the right one. Alright, well, this side has stopped paying out. I assure you that was just random chance. Seriously. At least that's my thinking. That's the assumption I've been functioning under for so long. Let's try to watch this one closely. Alright, we got a penny. I guess I'll go over. Alright, that was actually... It started to seem a little bit scary, but I was actually trying to go for the one in the far right there. I just walked into the one in the middle by accident. I don't want any of this shit! I want keys! You have a very simple job. Just shuffling these skulls around. Thank you, attack fly. Or pretty fly. Seriously, you'd run out of keys? I saw you had some earlier. My fucking god. Okay, bombs, cool, yeah. Sign me up. Pennies, yeah. Only have 84 of those right now. Pockets are all not heavy enough. Okay, you know what? After this, you get one more play, and then you're gonna blow up. We're gonna get a little more money here, possibly a blood bag. Unlikely, but possibly. Okay, thank you very much. If you don't have keys, you're fucked, buddy. Alright, you brought this on yourself. Goodbye, my friend. Not interested. Okay, so we got a half heart and another bomb. Awesome. So, that was kind of a waste of time, although I guess we did get a dollar out of it. But what good is a dollar if we can't do anything fucking with it? Now this room is gonna be a pain in the fucking ass. Apologize if I'm swearing a little bit here. Seriously! I feel like... Making dun 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 dun. I feel like I've had the worst luck. Maybe not the worst luck, but bad luck. Very recently and very commonly in Isaac lately. And look at these rooms, like, I can't do enough damage to take these guys out without having to employ, like, the greatest dodging skills since the Matrix. We're finally almost done here, oh my god. Tarot card is the world, sure, why not? Show us where to go. Obviously, we're gonna hold on to this Emperor card. Maybe, if we get lucky, we can find a key or something. Maybe bomb our way into the secret, or into the shop, or into the item room? It's unlikely, but I guess because stranger things have happened. Probably stranger things have happened. So this is like our slow run. So I know exactly what I'm gonna call this video. I'm gonna call it Slow Ride. In honor of the Foghat song with the dopest bass line of all time. Come on. Thank you. Oh right, we can't go to the shop. That would make things far too easy. Alright, greedheads. You guys go to town. The slow is actually kind of making this harder on me because it also changes the angle of the shots. If I didn't have the slowing effect, I could just stand in the middle and these guys would never hit me. Because their shots just, like, fork around. However, that's not the case when you slow it. You have to have a little bit of dodging aptitude, but not very much. Which is good, because I don't have very much. Seriously, we're not going to get a key here. I'm resigning myself to that fact. There's nothing that can be done about it. That's why these flat penny keys, stuff like that, rusty key, they're all so valuable. Okay, it's gonna slow you down. It does function as like a mini Necronomicon as well, but it doesn't really do that much damage. It seems. There we go. We're gonna go check out the item room, because the item room cannot possibly have greed in it. It might have a shitty item, but it's not gonna have greed in it, so that's positive. When you only get one key, that's how I usually prefer things to go. Cool. We get Magneto. It's not horrible. It's not good. It's not horrible, though. Of course, the trade-off is that we could have gone to the shop. Maybe we would have run into greed, but if we didn't, there's a chance we could have bought something and bought a key as well and gone to the item room in addition to that. That's kind of more of a high-risk, high-reward style, I guess, and that actually probably would have been a better strategy for me to employ, because I kind of need that high-risk strategy right now, but we're still alive and ticking here. Don't even have to use a bomb to get to that second secret room, which contains a slot machine, or sorry, a fortune teller, which we'll play 8 times. You get 8 chances to make my life better here. Give me a better trinket, give me a ton of spirit hearts, I don't care. Alright, I mean, the fortunes are nice. Tarot card is Hierophant, that's good. You've earned your stay here. Well, I'm sorry, my fortune. You know what? You get the 75 cents now, because of the way you paid out before. Excellent. That was a wise decision on my part now, I think. Left hand turns regular chest into red chest. Sure, we'll give it a try. And now you get the 70 cents. Because you keep paying out with some decent stuff. I like the cut of your jib. Bloody Penny gives us red hearts when we pick up pennies. I'll go with the left hand for now. Better pay out on this one. Okay, the spirit heart's cool, but maybe we'll play the 65 cents. Because if it keeps paying out with spirit hearts every 5 cents, we can get like nearly 20 here. And that would be great for us, because we started with roughly 99, maybe a little bit less. Ooh, and we got judgment too. Oh, it's health judgment. I don't care, let's try it. Health judgment could end up saving us here. Monstro's tooth, really, man? That's what you're gonna give us? That's shitty. Okay, and this card is 2 of clubs, doubles our bombs. Why not use that right away and hold on to the Emperor card? You get the 60 or 58 cents now. Because you're paying out. Should probably pick up the Lucky Toe just as long as we keep gambling, but I just don't really care that much, to be honest with you. It's our card. Our card is the Emperor, but we also have the Chariot card now. So this is your last attempt. I'm sorry, my friend, but you were very good to me. And the pill is... Fuck you! Balls of Steel. Wow, that was a great one. So we're going to use the Chariot on our boss here. Then we're going to come back here, waste a bomb, and pick up our Emperor card again. Because the longer we hold on to that Emperor card, the more valuable it becomes. Because obviously we can use that on a later floor. For example, an XL floor, and you know, just skip over like maybe the entirety of the Womb XL or something. That would be fantastic for us. Magneto's going to bring that bomb directly to us. And this bomb as well. And we're going to fight Pestilence, which will give us our second cube of meat. So I use the Chariot there, kind of out of necessity as much as anything else. Then we're quickly going to pop Spider Butt, slow this motherfucker down, do a little bit of damage. And then he will die. Maybe we'll get a deal with the devil, maybe we'll pick up Mom's knife, and this whole nightmare will be over. Spirit Heart drop on his account as well. That's really awesome. Okay, what do we get in here? That's Lord of the Pit. We can afford 2 for Lord of the Pit. That's a great item. I kind of preferred the days when there weren't that many deals with the devil items available, though. You know, back in the day where you're like, oh, we got to deal with the devil? It's almost certainly Brimstone or Mom's Knife, so that's fine with us. We're going to take our Emperor card. Do we want any of this stuff? I think the red hand, or the left hand, is a pretty decent trinket. I can't believe we're 25 minutes in and we're only going down to the depths. It's like 6 minutes of floor. Whatever, here we are. And of course it's going to be Necropolis. We're going to do some exploration to try to find our... Well, obviously Magneto is useless now, but whatever. Yeah, some exploration to try to find our item room. Possibly some keys along the way. I mean, oh, that was an accident, but wow! Happiest accident of all time. Maybe my luck isn't so bad anymore. Moon took us to the secret room. You know what? We are going to fight Greed here. We could just walk out, but... I'm going to fight him. Possibly pick up a steam sail. Who knows? Possibly pick up a quarter or something. Maybe this motherfucker will even drop a key. If nothing else, we're already more than halfway through. So let's build up half of a spider butt charge. Well, we got Steam Sale. Pretty much what I expected. So, to be honest with you, I kind of thought Moon was the one that took us to the item room. Well, that was bad damage. But what else is new, right? Forgot I had second level Super Meat Boy now, trucking along. I got so excited by that Lord of the Pit pickup. Didn't even think about how well we're doing now on damage. At least better on damage, decently on damage. Maybe well is a misnomer or an improper description, but maybe I'll explore this way. Who cares? Another fistula, whatever. We're gonna get as many of these things split as possible. The exact opposite of my normal fistula strategy. And then we're gonna pop Spider Butt. You know, it's chemical principle, really. The larger surface area you have, so the more pieces you break that fistula into, the higher the rate of reaction goes. So we are gonna do more damage that way. And we're gonna skip over the left hand to go with Cancer here, which is going to double our tier speed, or double our rate of fire, I should say. Very good trinket. Oh, come the fuck on. Still doing shit damage, apparently. Probably my favorite trinket in the game. Wish that you didn't have to hold on to the Polaroid when you left the Depths Part 2. Sadly, you do, if you want to have a chance at the chest anyway. These things are hard to kill. Well, we got 19 bombs, so first things first. Second secret room contains another fortune teller. You know what? You get the 50 cents because I liked your brother. Seriously, hook me up here. Alright, well, key. That's good. I'll live with that. And if we don't have golden chests in here, we will open this. I was hoping we'd get another key, but hey, I'll take the spirit heart as well. Now this is probably going to be the hardest group of enemies we come across. So I didn't feel bad about using the spider butt on them. So I think after this, we maybe get zombies at the end and hoppers in the middle, maybe? Yeah, okay. Maybe I'm finally starting to remember what we get in these mob trap rooms. It seems weird to have hoppers in here. You think, like, maybe at one point those were supposed to be leapers, and then Ed was just like, no way, man. That's a little bit too crazy. Okay, so kill this dude. And then the last remaining Zambi. So, we're still looking for our item room, we're still looking for, you know, another key so we can go to the shop, and we're looking for our boss room as well. Lots of things to look for right now. Reminds me of a U2 song. I still haven't found what I'm looking for. I was thinking of, Elevation from the Tomb Raider soundtrack. Well, I got lucky to avoid taking damage there. We're gonna try to continue getting lucky. You know what Tiger Woods says? Two in the pink, one in the stink. No, that was the wrong Tiger Woods quote. It's, If you take her easy, and if she's easy, take her twice. No, it's... I'm thinking of... You gotta tickle the back of... Why did I do that? You gotta tickle the back of her knees. No, it's... You make your own luck. I ran out of fake Tiger Woods quotes. So now we have two keys. Imagine that. We could go to the shop and the item room on the same floor. And we've already fought greed here. So, we know that we're okay with respect. Why even go to this room? Like, this room has nothing. It was a dead end. Game over, man. Well, not really. We're still doing okay. So let's get these guys all to split up. Then, spider butts. Thank you, turret, for helping me out there. Now, we should go to our shop. It's back here. How did I not notice that before? Probably because I didn't have any keys back then. Can't believe we're fucking only on Necropolis 1. My god, this is slow. Mom's knife, I beg of you. Book of Revelations. Take it because we have so much money. We might as well amass spirit hearts like crazy. Where did our Emperor card go? I'm reckless right now. Bought out the whole shop because you never know if we're going to get another chance. And we'll take Spider Butt with us. So we picked up a couple Spirit Hearts there. We spent way too much money on not enough items, but we have way too much money and not enough opportunities to spend them. So, whatever. I mean, I bought that slot machine just to blow it up. That's how baller I am. We gotta find Treasure Room item room down here. That's our Emperor card, which we'll save at least for the womb. Might possibly last a little bit longer than that as well. I mean, if we can save it for the chest, if we can save it for the cathedral, then it all works out even better. But I'm not totally sure that we're gonna get to the chest. We'll probably get to the cathedral. The chest might be a bit of a stretch. Let's come down here. Okay, finally we've discovered our item room. And we can't afford to use our spider bot here. Take them out relatively easily. More keys, finally free-flowing. Miter, great item. Unfortunately, I also refer to this as like the life support item, because what often ends up happening is that the miter gives us just enough spirit hearts to slowly lose all of our health. But we're gonna try to avoid that. Hopefully we'll pick up some items here. Cough, cough, mom's knife, that will allow us to parlay this added health that we're going to get, most likely, into, you know, some better possibilities. Hopefully. But we shall see. So we're fighting the pony! Pony's gonna give us the ability to fly. Whatever. Already have it, buddy. And by and large, pony is not a superbly difficult boss. Helmet can be annoying as fuck, but, you know, we better get used to it, because from here on in, we pretty much fight this dude every single room. So, normally with the pony, you want to focus on one of them. I'm kind of breaking my own rule here. Usually the helmet dies faster. I think it has less HP. And generally speaking, the helmet actually doesn't have a lot of HP. There, it's finally dead. Now this, I think we're right for a deal with the devil room right now. We didn't take very much damage. Whatever. Down to the next floor. We picked up a spirit heart, at least. Could rush our way into the boss room, but why bother, right? We can't leave after that. This is our last chance for a treasure room, last chance for a shop. Although we can still, now with the miter, get libraries on our later floors. Man, 31 minutes. Finally gonna be fighting Mom. So another spirit heart again. Miter helping us build up a stock here, but do I have the one up? I do have the one up as well. I totally forgot about that. Look at this, how long this run has been for how little progress we've made so far. Okay, just wanted to make sure I could kill that dude before he managed to kill me. I mean, he wasn't gonna kill me, but fire at me. You get the picture. That's a flat penny that gives us a key every time. We're gonna use this for at least a while. The reason being, I want to build up a stock of keys right now. We might not have another opportunity, and keys have been scarce this run. But we want to build up a stock of keys right now that will allow us to go to the chest and open all the items down there. Because there's nothing worse than getting down to the chest and being like, oh, I can't rely on any items here. I mean, the items you get in those chests, you know, routinely are horrible. But they're all you got, really, at that point. So we'll keep moving around here. It's another good opportunity for the spider brut. So what we're going to do here is just, you know, whenever possible, rotate ourselves from one side to the other, because the shots can't fire over rocks. So if we just hang out over top of these rocks, there is nothing that can be done except, you know, for these flies to chase us. But I think those will disappear when I go into this room. Now, I am going to use a key to open this golden chest. Northern Lion, you just said keys are scarce. Why would you do that? Unsubbed, dislike the video. You made a mistake. The answer is, you know, we have flat penny now, so there's always a chance that we're going to get a lot of coins in these chests, and the chests containing coins now give us a chance to pick up keys with every single coin we pick up as well. Case in point, I'm not trying to say I told you so, but check it out. That worked totally fine, exactly as I anticipated. We used one key and gained three keys, as well as a little bit of money that, you know, is functionally, I'll admit, worthless. Unless we come across, you know, a fucking Tiffany in here or something. So there's our boss room. That's not necessarily the most important thing in the world to us right now. But it will be soon. So I'm hoping for more coin drops here. Spirit hearts, of course, very useful as well. And we're going to get a lot of those as a result of the miter. But we're going to need a lot of those, because after this floor, shit's going to start getting a little fast and furious. Not the movie, I'm talking about my nickname for my masturbation sessions. Not furious, like, furiously masturbating. I mean furious, like, I'm angry. I'm like, why am I masturbating? I don't know where I'm going with this. Okay, so let's go to our secret room. Fetus in a jar? Well, lots of money. Oh, that's good, right. Lots of keys. We're at the point where we could possibly consider getting rid of the flat penny trinket. I mean, we're gonna have to very shortly anyway. Yeah, we might as well amass as many keys as we possibly can while we are here. My god, this is a laborious run so far. Let's continue on this way. Slow these douchebags down. pretty much hate any room with blue spikes in it. Especially if the enemies are difficult to dodge, because you are going to accidentally dodge into them a lot. Probably several times. Or at least maybe not dodge directly into them, but dodge into a situation where they can now proc and hit you. So, just gonna stay down here, hanging out over top of these gaps here so that the heads can't do anything to me. Although, the hearts still can. Probably my least favorite enemies in the game now. Worse than zombies for sure. Although I guess, I don't know, there are other enemies that are also pretty dickish. Bring on, Chubb, I got 25 bombs, I just realized that. Pretty much shot that one right into his mouth. Well, that came out not the way I anticipated it to. Although I suppose I should have anticipated it. Alright, that was very easy. I thought we'd get a key out of that, but we did not. Don't think it'd be like it is, but it do. So, we're gonna rely on our central turret here. Take out a lot of these guys, and so far so good. It did a really good job there. And our second secret room, finally, there is something over here. It's not just a complete dead end and waste of our time. Although, you know, the second secret room is oftentimes just a complete dead end and waste of our time. Well, I guess because of the way that the rooms are set up, the second secret room is always a dead end, but also oftentimes a waste of our time. Blow up, blow up. Ah, he was so close to death. Well, that was lucky. Lover's card, not really useful for us right now, maybe in the future, but we're gonna hold on to this Emperor card to the next floor for sure. Awesome. Just terrible red chest. That's why I don't find the left hand all that useful. I mean, sometimes you can get good items, but I think it's like 1 in 10 you get a good item, and the rest of the time you just get, you know, spiders or something. So, we're looking for shop item room. Yeah, sure, why not? Trading a key for a range upgrade is not horrible. This is a golden poop. You don't come across those all that often. Definitely less than once every run. Maybe once a day when I'm playing Isaac. Usually I play like 2 or 3 games per day. When I'm recording anyway. And then take a couple days off. Maybe 1 golden poop per day. So usually this means money. Should really focus on taking out the source here. I.e. these actual heads as opposed to just shooting the flies. If we had rage, we would employ the opposite strategy, but we don't have rage. Alright, so get off my fucking case. More money? That means more keys, probably. I only got 1? I think that might be because I was hanging out over top of the hole the entire time. I mean, you know how much I love hanging out over top of the hole, but at some point you just gotta come back to land. So we're gonna open this up, of course. Red patch. I mean, we want to stick with the flat penny for now, actually. The red patch would have given us rage, though. We have the candle now. Candle's a good item. I like it. We got rid of spider butt. That sucks. Spider butt's been good to us. But, wow, I'm taking way too much stupid damage. Candle's gonna be better for us. Finally, we find the item room. And also a boss trap room, which I can get to by way of the secret room. That's really useful, actually. You don't need me to tell you that, but I'm gonna. Okay, so in here, hourglass, terrible. We're gonna go, can we bomb our way out of the arcade? That was lucky. Can we bomb our way out of the arcade? Yes, and we could get Blue Baby as well, but it's not necessary at this point. Bomb our way into the boss trap room, see what we get. HP upgrade, certainly. I'm gonna put a bomb down here just to see if I can bomb my way out, because I can't. I would rather bomb my way out than waste my time in here, but... And potentially risk some spear hearts as well, but you know, we've got the candle now, so we're doing some crazy damage. If there's a benevolent force in this universe, they will allow me to get Mom's Knife in conjunction with the candle and flying, so I can live my dream of having the most dickish run ever. And then we got Peep, what's up, Peep? I can't believe, like, we already fought Peep on this run. That feels like it was 20 minutes ago. It was probably 2 floors ago. If even that, honestly. Peep's nearly dead. Mission accomplished. Another key, awesome. That way we'll just walk our bitch ass all the way back down here to the boss room where we are finally ready to fight the boss. And I think it's gonna go fine. I hate to ditch all these sweet trinkets on this floor, but we don't have Mom's purse because we didn't get any keys until halfway through the game, so we didn't have the opportunity to visit some shops. But now things are, we're cooking with gas, things are moving forwards, we're going to get treasure here. And we're probably going to hope for a, I guess a Womb XL, and then I can use that Emperor card to its, that's stupid, use the Emperor card to its full effect. But if I have to save it for the chest, or if I have to save it for the cathedral, those are both worthwhile opportunities as well. I'm taking some dumb damage here. Let's not deny that. But I'm also doing some dumb damage as well. It's not really dumb, but I'm doing it. Good advice for anyone. Okay, Polaroid. Now we have this, which could be risky for us, but could be awesome as well. Pretty fly. All right. So now we got much better defense. I found pills. Why not take those? Now this is the moment of truth. Good, please. Bombs are key. Yes. And then we will leave with this existing setup. 11 bombs is totally fine for what we need to do. This is Womb 1, not Womb XL. So we will just explore. We found our second secret room as well. Well, I don't want any of this shit because it could possibly give me the tick, which I don't want. That doesn't help us out really all that much. Now I could go crazy and start going to that self-sacrifice room as well. Let's just be reasonable. Start thinking more normally here. Right, I forgot I can fly, so I don't have to worry about the creep. Excellent, picking up money here. Burning fools, how to get burned, how to get burned, how to get burned! It got burned by this blue candle. Which is perfect for me in this current situation, because I was doing so little damage. I think we should be able to get through this very, very quickly. Compared to what we were doing before. If only we could have Spider Butt and Blue Candle in conjunction with one another. Now there's, I guess we kind of do have Spider Butt and Blue Candle in conjunction with one another because of our slowing ability here. So, let's keep exploring. We are obviously just on the lookout for the boss room. We're not really looking for anything else. Not looking for anything serious right now, just looking for the boss room. One more left. Oh, that was close. He almost got me there. And I'm feeling like we're in the right decision, or we've made the right decision here. We're going in the right direction. So maybe sideways? Judgment. Perfect. Give me some health upgrades, man. What's the tarot card for? Empress. That's a good card. We can leave. We can use the Empress card on this boss and then come back and take the Emperor card. So that's fine. Yeah, there we go. HP upgrade, what did I tell you? So we're getting dangerously close to either boss room or dead end territory here. Have I seriously been holding that Emperor Tarot card since the first fucking floor? Did I seriously take damage there? Am I seriously starting every sentence with "did I seriously"? Answer, yes. So, boss, nope. This is getting a little silly, game. Work with me here. We both want the same thing. A nice cool drink and a cold shower because it is hot as balls right now. Do you have anything useful in here? Possibly, but I don't know if I want to risk it. So this is like our last opportunity to see if the boss room's here. And I'm starting to doubt it, actually. It's always nice when you guess right. When you guess wrong, man, feels like a personal failure. And a professional failure, I guess, technically. But in any case, it could be above this next room that we enter. Ah, what did I tell you? So we're basically just gonna do 4 candle shots on these guys. 1 candle's enough to take them out, but I don't want to spook them by shooting them with my regular bullets. And of course, candles, so useful for those Isaac Blue baby fights. So we got more health again, Emperor's card is ready to fight death. We're gonna get a 3rd level Meat Boy. That's really useful, actually, possibly. Again, very useful for those Blue Baby Isaac fights, assuming that he actually gets his butt in there. Isn't always guaranteed. Don't be an asshole about this one, death. Just let me have it. death dead. Time to take out his pony. We got a cube of meat, possibly a deal with the devil. Where we could possibly get mom's knife. We'll see, that's my dream come true. Will we get the pact? Sure, let's take it. Guppy's tail could be useful as well, but I'd really just wanted the extra tears and damage. And your shots are a little bit bigger, that usually means that they are better as well. And we can get our Emperor card, go down to the next floor. Probably not going to use our Emperor card on that floor as well. We're due for like an hour-long run here. Because we started so fucking slowly. If we got Mom's knife, it would have been over. We would have fit two runs in by now. It's so hot, I can't even focus on what the fuck I'm saying. Okay. Oh, I forgot about third level Meat Boy. What's up, man? Do some chewing, please, because I'm taking way too much damage against these fucking lasers. Spirit Heart, very useful. Why not? We have the candle. Teleport! What a waste! Obviously, we don't want anything to do with that. So we're just gonna back the fuck up. Try firing in these flames whenever they are gonna be best used. What do we have after? I don't know if I've ever been to a mob trap. Oh, I've obviously been to a mob trap room in the womb before. Gonna just fight single Loki? Really? That's the second phase of this? It's not difficult at all. I'm not gonna complain, I guess. Oh, we got three, right, because it's a mob trap room. Not a boss trap room. So, as Chubb comes for us, we'll just hit him with our sweet-ass blue candle. How do you like this shit, man? Not at all is probably the answer that you were thinking of. So, after your death, we'll pick up the key. We will not use the teleport because it's totally useless to us. And we'll hide out over these rocks and let Meat Boy mostly do the work here. It's gonna take him 100 years, apparently. No, don't go for the... Yeah, there you go. Well, that almost involved us taking some... Really? How did I take damage there? Damn it. Okay. Oh, okay. Meat Boy, you gotta chew on those hearts, buddy. The masks are hard and tasteless, but the hearts... Scrumptious. Full of bullets. Ace of Spades. Sorry, the Ace of Spades is a trinket that I don't want now. At all, actually. I have to stick with the Polaroid, what can I say? Gotta hold this until at least we finish the cathedral. And then after that, we're probably not gonna come across any trinkets anyway. So how do we do this? Well, there's one way. First, we take out Guts. Or special Guts here. And then we just walk this dude on top of the spikes right here. And our pill is... something amazing. Tears up. Yeah, I'll take that. Now, I'm hoping against hope that we've chosen the right direction again. I'm also hoping against hope that the miter comes through and gives us some more spirit arts, because it's been a little bit lean lately. I knew this was going to happen. Well, you know what? We'll play this till we get down to 50 cents. And we'll definitely not get close to it every single time, because we want to make sure we don't accidentally pick up the tick. The tick is like the ultimate troll item in the Binding of Isaac. It's starting to spook me. I'm just gonna blow it up. It hurt me? I was so far away from it! I couldn't see the bomb because of the fortune teller. Excuses, excuses, but still. Have mercy, please. Well, that was awful damage as well. So far, it's all coming apart at the seams. It's like as soon as I got Platinum God, my hand was just like, I don't need to play Isaac anymore. We did choose the right direction, though. It's very positive. Only brain dudes left. So we're fighting Mom's Heart here. I know it's hard to believe since we're 50 minutes into the video, but I think we're gonna fight Mom's Heart, use our Emperor card right away, because my thinking is then we can get to the chest as soon as possible if we're able to survive that boss fight against Isaac. And then we'll get four items on the chest immediately, which could potentially make things easier for us. So we're gonna skip over the easier of the two floors to try to get the items that might help us out a little bit. Yeah, Meat Boy, you just stick around here. It should be pretty easy for us. You go attack Mom's Heart. I'll throw in the candles here to do the extra damage. Candle's not strong enough to take out all these enemies in one hit, though, which is kind of a problem. I guess it just bounced off the poop as well, which sucks. Hey, here we are. Probably should have used a bomb there, but yeah, it just bounces. It bounces off the heart. That's what it does. That's why it doesn't kill all the enemies. This thing's still alive? Briefly, anyway. Alright, so we're almost at continuously firing bombs territory. Feel bad for Duke of Flies, man. He doesn't know what he's getting himself into in this fight. I don't care if you attack Chubb or you attack the heart, but please do something. Alright, I think Meat Boy's gonna just continuously attack the heart. That's cool with me. One more candle, we should be able to end this. Pick up a spirit heart, thank you, Mitre, and move on to the next floor. When we will go to the secret room right off the bat, I guess. Nope, and we will leave, and then we will use our Emperor card right away. And who knows, maybe we'll get another Emperor card on this fight. Kind of unlikely, but, you know, possible. So we got a lot of things going in our favor here. The candle blowing up the shots, we also have the, the three things surrounding us. Meat Boy chewing constantly. Standing in a position where I'm apparently impossible to hit. I've only taken one hit of damage so far. It's pretty solid. And Isaac is about half dead. Stay still, we'll be fine. 2 hits of damage is fine too. It's gonna be a little bit harder in a second once we get these angel fetuses coming in. Still going strong here. Okay, run. Somehow we managed to get out of there. And even when we're not doing damage to Isaac, we are doing damage to Isaac by way of the Meat Boy that we have upgraded here. He's up. Almost dead. Almost dead. Okay, so we get a half heart we can't use. And 2 more angel fetuses. And then we are ready for the chest. So I'd consider this a victory so far. Now is the moment of truth. Relic. Kind of useless because we're getting it so late, but not bad. Obviously, Mini Mush is okay, speed and range. The Doctor's Remote is awful. And a remote detonator for bombs. So we didn't necessarily, strike it rich. Right there. We're gonna have a very hard time moving forwards, but at least we got here. It's progress considering A, the last video, and B, how badly things started here. I consider this to be a positive change. Positive result, all things considered, anyway. And we still have a chance. I found pills, kind of frustrating. We've been getting that an awful lot. Well, I dodged directly into that. That was smart of me. So we are in Red Heart territory here. Not the best place to be. In fact, we're quite low in Red Heart territory now. I think this one is the head, which I almost dodged directly into the shot of. Now, you should be dead. You should be dead. You should be dead. You are dead. I found pills again. Why? Just like, I'm thinking maybe if we take 10 of these, it'll give us a health upgrade by accident or something. Who knows? So let's continue exploring down here. We're fast enough to get around all these enemies. But this could still be a little tricky. Actually, you know, if we ran into like 10 of these rooms on our way to the boss room, I think that would give me my best chance of success. Should go without saying, by the way, that we need way more health if we're going to take out the boss. 4 might be enough if I had like my best Blue Baby run ever. And it's possible with the candle and the items that I have. I would love to get Guardian Angel as well. Bob's Rotten Head, worthless, making me wish I kept the D6. Demon Baby, actually really useful. Gonna allow us to do a little bit extra damage here. So we reached another dead end. Awesome. And I took some damage there. They should make everything on the chest do like triple damage as opposed to double damage. Now that would be fucking crazy. Still not holding out a lot of hope here, as you can probably guess. Almost walked into that poop because I'm faster than my own shots. Sorry, faster than my own shots. Okay, so keep this up. I am scared. I seem to be getting hemmed into a corner pretty easily here. Please drop a full health pill. It's a very simple request. It would mean the world to me. The spirit heart's cool too. And we have another dead end here. That's good, you know? It gives me a chance to get more items. This would be a good situation. If we'd gotten Guppy's Tail, we could possibly pick up some solid items here. Because, of course, every golden chest in the chest contains a good item. Well, it contains an item. Perhaps not a good item, but an item nonetheless. An item that can be used beyond bombs and keys. And we made it out of this room. Okay, tarot card is the World, yes. Okay, so we can get to the boss room very quickly. Oh god, I walked into the poop. Okay. There is the slightest chance of our own victory here. It's not high at all. It's very, very slight. Is that a special pestilence? And what is the other one? Death. Oh man. Well, let's take out pestilence first because he should be easier. Oh, okay, now it's bad. Now things are not good. Alright, death. I'm knocking on your doorstep. Meat boy, you're kinda useless right now. You don't see this enormous harbinger of fate in front of you? Death should be dead. Wasn't trying to make any, like, overarching metaphysical statements by saying that. Okay, there we go. We got a spirit heart, so we can survive a little bit longer. Can we now bomb our way into and out of these, shop secret rooms? Or a chest secret? Oh, come on, greed. Should have expected it, but still. Can't bomb my way into the boss room from here? Well, why am I here then? Just gonna exit. And again, try to make our way over here to the boss room. Many things could go wrong right now. Many, many things, but I think we might survive out of this room. It's a ticking time bomb now. How long can we actually last? Can we reach the hour mark? Nope! That was fast. Oh right, we have the 1-up, I totally forgot. Maybe we have a chance now. Remember that you can't bomb your way out of rooms on the chest, so I can't just bomb my way out of this bloat room into the boss room. Bloat is always a problem for us. Because of the lasers, of course, but Meat Boy can take care of him. I hit the eye, that was a bad mistake, but we're still ticking here, so it's okay. And okay, we got another secret room. I guess we can bomb our way into the secret rooms, we just can't bomb our way out of them. Lest we, you know, do what I tried to do, which is basically like skip half of the world. That doesn't feel like an exploit, that's actually a legitimate tactic, I feel. Another spirit heart? Dare I say! Unless we get totally screwed on this room right here, or totally screwed on Blue Baby, we might have a chance. Not a good chance. I say as I take 2 damage there. 3 damage. Maybe we don't have a chance to even get to Blue Baby. I mean, we did just fight 2 Wretched at the same time. And survive. And pick up a single bomb for our troubles. Oh man, okay. Second secret room, it's your chance. Your time to shine. Oh my god. We might very, very slightly have an opportunity to succeed here. This is remarkable. Don't get hit by the flies. That's the only thing that's changed. That and the abundance of homing shots now. Okay, now that... Meat Boy, get close. Get in. Get in there. Hit him with the left. Hit him with the right. I gotta do some, like, circling here. There we go. Now Meat Boy can get in there. Hopefully that doesn't end up killing me. But it didn't get Meat Boy in there fast enough. Didn't get Meat Boy in there fast enough. The Northern Lion story. So we're at half health. He's at half health. It's a fight to the finish. Fists will fly at this location. We're going strong here. Oh, okay, Meat Boy, continue chewing. It's the only thing to send you back to the fucking sausageers if you don't fix this. Come on, Rachel. Oh, okay, here we go. Moment of truth. Oh, I walked into the angel fetus. I really thought we had it there. But in any case, that was an exciting run. Actually recorded with my right microphone, which feels good too. But as always, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time.